Hey, good evening. You're welcome to PG's Physics Classroom. Once again, for another episode of our lecture. We are continuing with the questions that our colleagues sent in to solve for them. And this question is on linear motion under kinematics. The question reads like this. Two particles P and Q move towards each other along a straight line MN, which is 51 meters long. P starts from M with velocity 5 meters per second and constant acceleration 1 meter per second squared. Q starts from N at the same time with velocity 6 meters per second and at a constant acceleration of 3 meters per second squared. Remember, the key to this question is that the two of them started at the same time. Please take note of that. They started at the same time. Good. So find the time when the A particles are 30 meters apart, B the particles meet each other, and then C when the velocity of P is 3/4 the velocity of Q. Good. So let's look at the solution to the first part. That is when the particles are 30 meters apart. Now remember that we have this information about the question, about the particles that are engaging the motion in the question. The initial velocity for P is 5. Its acceleration, its uniform acceleration is 1 meter per second squared. The initial velocity for Q is 6 meters per second, and its acceleration is 3 meters per second squared. Remember, keep this information very well in your head. We may use it. So when the two particles start the motion, the distance between them is 5 meters. Now, they start at the same time, move towards each other, such that at a point, when Q has reached this point and P has reached this point, the distance between the two of them is 30 meters. So we say that let the distance covered by P be X, and the distance covered by Q will be 21 minus XY, because the total distance between them is 51. So if the distance covered by P is X, 51 minus X minus 30, that will give us the distance covered by Q. 51 minus X minus 30, that will give us the distance covered by Q. So when you solve that, it will give you 21 minus X. So we select this Newton's equation of motion. Why this equation? You know, we have three of the equations of motion. The other two equations, V is equal to U plus AT, and V squared is equal to U squared plus 2AS, have final velocity component inside. And in this question, we don't have enough information about the final velocity. The only information we have is on the distance traveled. So for that matter, the best equation to be selected for this particular question is the equation that involves the distance without the final velocity. If we select that, we'll be in trouble. And that is the technique that we use to solve kinematics questions involving the Newton's equations of motion. When a question is given to you, write the information given to you in the question down. Ask yourself, which of the Newton's equations of motion is suitable to solve this question? Then select that equation, use it, and don't think twice. If your calculator is correct, your final answer is correct. Good. So we are going to use this equation for both P and Q. So when we consider the distance covered by P, we substitute the values X and the initial velocity and the acceleration for P in, and that gives us this equation. X is equal to 5t plus t squared over 2. Then we consider the distance covered by Q, and we put in the distance covered by Q, 21 minus X is equal to 6t plus 3t squared over 2. Let's call that one equation 2 and this one equation 1. So when we substitute equation 1 into equation 2. That is, anywhere we see x, we put this one, the root of this one there. That gives us this final equation, 21 minus 5t plus t squared over 2 is equal to 6t plus 3t squared over 2. Now, solve this equation yourself, and you arrive at this final quadratic expression. So we solve this quadratic expression, we get two t values, t1 equals 1.5 seconds and t2 equals minus 7 seconds. Remember, time is a scalar quantity, you cannot take a negative value, so we pick the positive one. So therefore, t1 is 1.5 seconds. This t1 is the time taken by k to travel from here to here, the time taken by p to travel from here to here. Remember, they both started at the same time. So they will spend the same time at any point they have gotten to, irrespective of their positions, the distance they have covered. They will spend the same time because they started at the same time. Good. Then we solve, we go to the second question. When the two particles meet, we want to find a time when the two particles are going to meet. So the same way, let us remember the equation, the information given to us in the question. It is very important because that is going to guide us to select our values, our equation to be used. So we consider the two bodies. The difference between this question and the previous one is that here the two of them are meeting each other. So there's no distance between them. But in the previous one, there was a distance of 30 meters between them. So what this means is that if the distance covered by P is X, the distance covered by X is going to be, the distance covered by Q, sorry, is going to be 51 minus X. So we select the same equation, we consider the distance covered by P, and then we get this equation as our initial equation for equation 1 for P. Then we consider the motion of Q, and then we get this equation. You see that the only difference between these equations, even this one, there's no difference, but the only difference is here we have 51 minus X. The previous question, we had 21 minus X. So they are almost the same. They are almost the same. So when we substitute equation 1 into equation 2, and then we solve it, we finally get this equation. Then when we solve this equation, we get this quadratic equation. We solve the quadratic equation, and then we get these two t values. T1 equals 3 seconds, and t2 is equal to negative 8.5 seconds. Remember, like I've said earlier, the time cannot be negative, so we pick t is equal to 3 seconds. What that means is that in 3 seconds, the two particles, irrespective of the speed they are traveling with, irrespective of the accelerations, the two of them will meet at a point, irrespective of the distances they have covered, because they started at the same time. That is a clue that you shouldn't forget. We go to the third question, which says that the velocity of P is 3/4 of the velocity of Q. What that means is that the two of them started at different points, but they will get to a point where the velocity of P becomes equal to 3/4 of the velocity of Q. So let us still remember our information given to us in the question. Now, let's assume that at the point where the velocity of P is 3/4 of the velocity of Q, P has gone to this point and Q has gone to this point. Of course, they may not have met. It's possible that they may have met and they have passed each other. It's possible that they have not met. So we don't know that, so we select any one of them and then we use that. That is not going to affect our answer anyway. So at that point, the velocity of P is 3/4 the velocity of Q. So let the velocity of Q be VQ, the velocity of P becomes 3/4 of VQ. So over here, we don't have information about the distance covered, but we have information about the velocity of the two particles. So we select an equation that involves velocity without distance, else we'll be in trouble. So we select this equation, V is equal to U plus AT, one of the Newton's equations of motion. Then the velocity of P, we put in the values, and that will give us this. Remember, V is equal to U plus AT, so the velocity of P is going to give us this, is equal to 5 plus 1T, but we don't write a 1. Let's call it equation 1. Then, the velocity of Q, we consider it. We'll put in the value that is going to give us VQ is equal to 6 plus 3T. Remember the acceleration, the initial velocity. So when we substitute equation 2 into equation 1, remember V is equal to this. And 3, 4, V is equal to this. So we substitute this equation into this. That will give us this expression. We solve this expression and it gives us 18 plus 90 is equal to 20 plus 40. We carry 40 across the equal sign, and that will give us 5T. We carry 18 across the equal sign, and that will give us 2. So 5T is equal to 2. We divide the 2 by 5, and that gives us 0.4 seconds. So, brothers and sisters, this is how this particular question is supposed to be dealt with. So, thank you very much. I want you to subscribe to my YouTube page and then get access to this video. Share it among your friends. Get them to also subscribe so that anytime I do a video on solving a question or giving a lecture or teaching, you will be able to get it. Thank you very much. And God bless you. Thank you.